Jeremy Wheeler with the forecast.
Okay, let's take a look at it. What we've got, big Hurricane Irma out in the Atlantic, and this is moving off to the west and southwest at the moment, 15 miles an hour. We got an eye present at the moment, and this is moving in a direction where you're starting to see the eye. Before, it was clouded over a little bit, but now it's a sign of a strong hurricane. The pressure has actually dropped as the winds have come up. The 8 a.m. update, here it is. And so 947 millibars. It was in the 960s. The lower the pressure, the stronger the storm, so it has increased. Now, it's forecast to move as a major hurricane towards the northern part of the Lesser Antilles, the Virgin Islands, Puerto Rico. It may get very close to this area. And, you know, if it moves over land for a while, that's going to change the forecast. It'll change the strength. Could interact with the Dominican Republic, Cuba, as we go into Saturday, Friday into Saturday, and possibly the Bahamas. So there's a lot of opportunities for change as the forecast comes through here. A lot of the models do bring it just north of Cuba, though. And, you know, a lot of the models have trended southward. You know, the other day, they were up here. They were clustered around South Carolina and North Carolina. Well, now they've kind of shifted down more towards Florida. There's a couple which take it a little bit between the Carolinas. That's new. That just came out in the last half hour. But I think still the average, the clustering is towards Florida. So there's a higher confidence that it's going to move down that way. But let's take a look. Here's two other models that we use, very important ones, the GFS and the European. The European model takes it just off of Florida. This would be Sunday, the GFS just off of Florida. Pretty close proximity to each other. But just keep in mind, they do send it northward after that point, especially the European model. Could still get very close to our area after we're interacting with land for a long period of time. So we're not out of the woods with that. We'll be watching it. There is a weak disturbance, which may be another tropical system as we get later into next week. But right now, we just want to take it one system at a time. And there's a lot of uncertainty with this. They changed quite a bit since yesterday. They're going to change again, so there's still a lot of uncertainty all the way through tomorrow and maybe even into Wednesday. And then we'll start getting more certain as it gets closer, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So watch for frequent updates. Take stock of your hurricane kits. You know, give them a check over, see if they need refreshing up. Has it been a couple years since you changed out the water? Is the food past the expiration? Things like that. It's mainly just a watch and see, but we want to watch it very closely in case the forecast brings it back up this way. Right now, there's nothing up this way except high pressure. We got beautiful conditions. We got a lot of sunshine out there, dry weather, and we're looking good for today. So lots of sunshine for the midday, the afternoon, going into the evening. It's a quick forecast. There's hardly a cloud in the sky. Overnight, clear skies, looking good. Temps mostly in the 60s. And then tomorrow, we're going to have a lot of sunshine. Again, looks good for the first day back to school, but it's going to be a little bit hotter. Highs will be in the 90s, low 90s. Today, we're starting off with the 60s. Actually, we started off in the 50s and 60s, but now we're well into the 60s. Got a few 70s to the south and east, and lots of sunshine. Lots of sun today. Low 80s for the Outer Banks, 84 for Virginia Beach and Currituck, 86 in Norfolk, 88 Chesapeake, and 86 in Portsmouth and Suffolk. We'll be in the mid-80s in Hampton and Newport News and Gloucester, upper 80s in Williamsburg to close to 90, and then 84 in Melfa. So a lot of sunshine today, heating things up. Tomorrow, we're even hotter. Highs in the low 90s for back to school. And then Wednesday, Thursday, we'll cool it down quite a bit, and we got rain moving in, quite a bit of rain. We get into Friday, Saturday, it might be a little on the cool side there. Highs near 70 for Saturday, so get ready for that. Some of that cool air may be impacting the track of Irma, and we'll have updates on it. Wavy News 10 at midday and 4 p.m.